Okay, if I didn't have long division, how would I figure out the answer to something like 137 divided by 3? Well, when we ask, what is 137 divided by 3, we are actually asking, if we split 137 into 3 equal groups, how big would each group be? And will there be anything left over? Let's just slide the dots one at a time into the 3 circles and see what we get. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, etc. In the end, we have 2 dots left over that we can't split into the 3 circles. Looks like that's our remainder. And in each of the circles, when we count them up, we find that we have 45 dots. So we know that 137 divided by 3 equals 45, with a remainder of 2. But let's face it, this is not a practical method for dividing large numbers. Let's go back and redo this in a more sensible way. We'll start out by organizing our 137 dots into sets of 10. I know that I need 13 sets of 10 to make 130. Another 7 dots on the side makes 137. Now I can once again divide the 137 dots into my 3 circles, but this time I can just slide my sets of 10 dots instead of individual dots, much quicker. 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Now I can tell just by looking that so far I've got 40 dots in each of the 3 circles. But I still have 1 set of 10 left over. When I put those 10 dots together with the 7 dots on the side, it means I've still got 17 dots to distribute among the 3 circles. Now I can use my knowledge of basic division. I know that I can split up those 17 dots into 3 groups of 5, with 2 left over. Then I can slide 1 group of 5 into each circle. I've now got 2 dots left over that can't be split up into the 3 circles, so those 2 are my remainder. I'm very happy to report that using this cleaner, pre-organized version of manual division, we've come up with the same answer as before. 137 divided by 3 still equals 45, with a remainder of 2. At this point, it's time to reveal the secret of the video. That thing we just did with the dots was actually just a visualization of long division. To prove it to ourselves, let's rerun the visualization on the left while we solve the same problem using long division on the right. On the left, recall that we started out with 13 sets of 10 dots to distribute evenly into the 3 circles. On the right, we start out our long division process looking at the dividend under the rooftop for a focus that is greater than or equal to our divisor 3. Since 1 is not greater than or equal to 3, the focus must be 13. Look at the connection between our focus of 13 on the right and our 13 sets of 10 on the left. Do you see the connection? They're the same thing. The next step in our long division cycle is division. 13 divided by 3 equals 4, ignoring the remainder for now, and we write 4 on our rooftop, carefully lined up over the focus. Over on the left, recall that we simply slid 4 sets of 10 into each of the 3 circles. See the connection between the 4 we just wrote on the long division rooftop and the 4 sets in each circle on the left? Yep, once again, they're the same thing. Next in the long division cycle, we multiply the number on the rooftop by the divisor. 4 times 3 equals 12, which we write down directly under the focus. Now the next step is to subtract. 13 minus 12 equals 1. We now do the long division cycle one more time to complete our work. Looking for our new focus, we know that 1 cannot be it because it's not greater than or equal to 3. So we pull down the next digit in our dividend, 7, giving us a new focus of 17. Wow, that took us several steps over on the right to finally catch up to our manual process on the left, where we have 17 dots remaining to distribute into the 3 circles. The long division cycle now calls again for division. 17 divided by 3 gives us 5, and we ignore the remainder for now. We write 5 on our rooftop, carefully lined up over the focus. Oh, yeah, over on the left, recall that we pre-divided our remaining 17 dots into 3 sets of 5 and slid 1 set of 5 into each circle. Mm-hmm. You see the connection. On the right, we do our next step of multiplication. 5 times 3 equals 15, which we write directly below the focus. Then we finish up by subtracting. 17 minus 15 equals 2. Since we don't have any digits remaining in the dividend to pull down, we're done, and that 2 at the bottom is our remainder, looking curiously similar to the 2 dots we have left over in the manual process on the left. So you see, while the long division cycle can certainly seem awkward and unnatural, it actually corresponds to a very sensible process of breaking things down little by little, like we did with the dots. And that's why long division works.